Previously on The Witcher 3.
Your Imperial Majesty.
Witcher, why have you come?
I've managed to find out where Ciri is.
Finally, I'd begun to doubt the wisdom of enlisting you. Bring her here at once.
The Wild Hunt's pursuing her. Kaer Morhen's the only place she'll be safe.
That was not a suggestion. I can defend my own daughter. Bring me Ciri.
I will, if that's what she wants. Guess not all of Vesemir's teachings have receded into oblivion.
A Witcher can forget to eat, to drink, to breathe even. But a Witcher never, ever forgets to care for his blade.
Yeah, I used to repeat that incessantly. Never tired of doing it either.
What creature was it?
Huh? Creature?
One that gave you the scar over your left eye. It's new. I don't remember it.
Souvenir from the cockatrice of Spala. Another addition to the collection. Nothing special. Yours has healed beautifully, though.
Avalok. He prepared some special ointments for me. But that was before the curse gripped him. Wonder where he is now.
We lifted the curse. He's at Kaer Morhen, waiting for you.
Are you serious? You must be. You'd not jest about something like that. A nice thing to wake up to.
You trust him?
Avalok? He's not let me down to date. Not once.
Why exactly is Avalok helping you? Sages have never been fond of humans.
He doesn't do it for me. It's about my power. As if it could ever be about anything else. Avalok tried to teach me how to control my ability. He was also making sure I didn't fall into Eridan's hands.
What's Eridan after? What's he want from you?
What everyone wants. Control of my powers. His homeworld faces annihilation. Eridan's decided to invade ours. Brilliant, wouldn't you say? Can't achieve much on his own, so he needs to bring an army. Except his navigators can't possibly move him and thousands of NL between planes. Their abilities won't allow it.
Whereas yours will.
Exactly. And if I die in the process, well, that's a necessary sacrifice.
How do you ever start traveling with Avalach?
As soon as I'd left you and Yen on the Isle of Avalon, I found myself pursued. Eridan and his Red Riders were on my heels. I fled through many worlds, many times. They came very close to catching me once. It was then that Avalach appeared, out of nowhere. He found a portal and took us to a world where Eridan couldn't find us for, perhaps half a year.
The world where Eridan couldn't find you, what was it like?
You wouldn't believe me if I told you.
Try me.
People there had metal in their heads, waged war from a distance, using things similar to megascopes, and there were no horses. Everyone had their own flying ship instead.
Ciri, stop fooling around.
Told you you wouldn't believe me. We should have stayed there.
So why'd you return?
I thought the Hunt had lost my scent for good. I thought I was safe. Besides, I wanted to find you. You and Yennefer.
You were looking for us. We were looking for you. Times I thought you were just a step away. Other times, felt like I was going around in circles.
I'm not surprised. There were times I fled pell-mell headfirst and forward.
So tell me how it happened, step by step.
Eridan located us mere moments after we landed on Ardskellig. Soon after, he and his riders surrounded us. I thought it was over, the end. Turned out Eridan had other plans. He produced the phylactery, uncorked it. A fog enveloped us, and Avalach began gasping for air.
That's how Eridan cursed Avalach, triggered his transformation into Uma?
Yes. He didn't wish to kill him. Humiliation, that's what he was after. But Avalach refused to succumb without a fight. He cast a spell that wrought havoc in the Hunt's ranks.
And in a full half of a forest on Ardskellig.
Yet it also gave us time to flee. Avalach opened a portal. I leapt in. He was supposed to follow right behind me, but something went awry. Impaired by the curse, he failed to reach the portal in time. We had agreed that if anything went wrong and we were separated, we would meet at his hideout in Velen.
But you failed to meet there.
Yes, we failed to. Once through the portal, instead of at Avalach's hideout, I landed right in the middle of Crookback Bog. I barely escaped the crones. And then there was the Baron. You know he took me hunting. I killed a wild boar with my sword.
I heard.
A coincidence, really. I had no desire to hunt that day, but it felt wrong to refuse. I'd taken nothing remotely resembling a hunting weapon. I simply hadn't intended to hunt. I was wandering through the forest, breathing deep the air. And then I heard a strange sound. Unsettling.
Boar attacked you?
Mm-hmm. Big as a bison, and lumbering straight at me. And all I had was my sword. Had to manage.
Did just fine, judging by how the Baron's men remember it.
Simple soldiers, the whole lot. But we got along splendidly. A shame I had to leave. Flee. But I didn't want to bring the Wild Hunt down on them. Apart from which, I knew by then the curse was progressing. So instead of looking for Avalach, I decided to find you and Yen.
So how do you even meet a man like Horson Jr.?
You and Yennefer were nowhere to be found, and I needed someone who could fix the phylactery. No ordinary craftsman would do. I needed a mage, one with extraordinary powers. Dandelion took it upon himself to help me. It was as if his honor depended on it. He arranged a meeting with a mage, but it proved a trap set by the temple guard.
Failed to mention that.
Probably didn't want to worry you. Later, we learned the guard did that sort of thing regularly, in the hope of nabbing anyone who collaborated with mages. We needed to find another way. That was clear.
Orson Jr.
Mm-hmm. I suspected it might not be the best idea, but I was desperate. I had no choice.
You suspected right. Orson was not the ideal partner in crime.
Damned simpleton got it in his head that we cheated him and kidnapped Dudu.
Who you promptly freed only to have to flee to Temple Isle. Great idea.
We hadn't planned it. Had no time to consider. We just bolted. I didn't even realize the guardsmen were driving me into a trap. Suddenly there I was, and I knew I had to disappear. At once.
And that's when you landed back in Skellige.
The shore of Hindisfjall. The first pleasant place that came to mind. Hjalmar and I used to swim there.
Wait, so you actually wound up there by accident? I thought you and Avalok had arranged something.
No, he simply sensed me use my power. Just as Eredin can sense where I am, where I travel. In fact, Eredin arrived soon after I did. His riders in tow. Once again, things happened quickly. Lofoten, the Hunt's attack, my flight. And then, dreams. Just dreams.
What did you dream? I've had nothing but nightmares lately. Pretty horrible.
Likewise, for the most part. In one, a monster grown from a stillborn child chased you. Ugh, that was horrible. I had a few nice dreams. For example, in one we sat around a fire, drinking good wine, and all around people danced and laughed.
I like that one a lot better.
Me too. But these dreams, and the others, ended in some tower. No matter what I'd dream, in the end, I would enter a tower.
Recognize it? Know where it might be?
Not sure. I don't think so. But there was something familiar about it, and something terrifying. The tower was stark and dead, but at the same time I felt I had to enter it.
Did you?
No. Dreams all ended with me searching for the entrance, and the last time, instead of the tower, I saw your grizzled face. If not for the scar over your eye, I'd have thought I was still dreaming.
I was afraid you were dead. Found some dwarves here. Said they'd try to wake you, but you were cold as ice, and you weren't breathing.
And yet you came in.
Who listens to dwarves these days? Speaking of which, they're probably getting antsy. We should go. Got a boat on the beach. Once we land, we'll head for Kaer Morhen. On horseback.
Right. Conventional means of travel. They're just better.
Though a portal would be quicker.
And draw Eredin to us immediately. Rather not risk it. Besides, I hate portals. Damn! Listen, we gotta think of a way to...
Welcome back, child.
Ciri!
My, you've grown beautiful.
No point standing around. Come on, time to greet the others.
You've not changed a bit. Any of you. All just like I remembered.
What?
Little sis.
They're all here. Everyone you asked for help. Avalok's resting in the tower, still in pretty bad shape. No reason to do it out here. Come inside.
Time's short. Wild Hunt will be here soon. Glad to see you, Triss.
Thank Yennefer. She's the one who invited me.
There'll be time to talk later. We should confer now.
Yen, you know the Wild Hunt better than anyone else. Tell us about the magic they use.
Their navigators open portals, rifts that we might counter with Dimeritium or our own magic. They also summon the frost that occupies the voids through which they travel.
There's just not enough of us. It'll be a hard fight.
Illusion.
Greetings, Geralt. If I'm to die today, I wish to look smashing for the occasion.
Get everybody together. Time to talk. Thank you for coming. The Wild Hunt will be here soon. They're coming for Ciri. Want to take her? We'll stop them.
How do you even know the Hunt'll show?
They always know where I teleport to. And they move from place to place in an instant.
So what's our plan?
Aridin, the King of the Hunt. He's confident. He'll strike hard, hoping to defeat us with the force of the blow alone. We've got to take the initiative away from him, foil his plan.
I'll generate a magic dome over the fortress. It will scatter them, force them to land in the woods.
If they're dispersed out in the woods, we could hunt down small groups of riders.
Got our first volunteer for the hunting party. I'm the second.
The Hunt will try to penetrate into the fortress through navigator portals. I can do nothing against this kind of magic, so you'll need to find and close as many as you can while hunting in the woods.
Lambert will make us dimeridium bombs. Remember the formula?
Of course.
Excellent. Erdin should work on the portals as well. I shall also give you each an amulet. Snap them in half and you'll become invisible, at least while you remain still or move slowly. Move abruptly, engage any foes, clash with them, and they will see you. Apart from that, they will be able to hear you and smell you. If you come across a large unit, do not attack. Signal Triss and she will provide support.
I'll look for your signal. Soon as I see it, I'll rain fire on the forest.
Ciri's most important in all of this. The Hunt's after her, and we have to defend her at all costs.
What do I do?
Stay inside the keep. If they break through, come inside. We'll all converge to help you.
Out of the question! I can look after myself.
No one doubts that, child. But remember the most important moment when hunting a monster?
Wait for an opportunity.
After the council, I'll give you an amulet. If you use it, a ball of fire will land where you're standing, just in case.
Remember, there's only a few of us. We have to help each other, work together. If anything goes wrong and the hunt puts us on the defensive, we pull back, make a stand at the gates of the fortress. The inner courtyard is our last line of defense. If we don't stop them there, we're doomed. What else do we have that we can use?
Since you plan to ambush the hunt in the woods, I could dig some trapping pits, blue stripe style.
Meaning?
Deep as the dark abyss, bottoms bristling with sharpened stakes.
I brought this Mahakaman mix. Flammable as bone-dry saltpeter and plowing sticks to anything. We fill some barrels, stack them in a narrow passage, and fire them up at an opportune moment.
You know we stand on a vast deposit of gas. If need be, I could open cracks in the earth, create explosions. I would need to prepare, though.
There's a laboratory and the workshop.
One thing to remember, we've got limited resources and even less time. We ought to decide what kind of weaponry will be most useful against the hunt.
Absolutely. We need to assign one type of weaponry each to the lab and workshop.
Who needs access to the lab?
I started brewing some potions. Like to finish, if you don't mind.
I could prepare more of those Witcher's traps, but I'd need all the lab equipment.
There aren't many of us, so we'll need to prepare as many traps as possible.
Let's talk about the workshop. Been wanting to fix that breach in the wall, but we'll need the same tools to clear the rubble from the armory.
Rubble?
Haven't you heard? Roof caved in a couple of years back. There's some excellent swords in there. Swords we could use.
Filling in the breach seems just as important. They come through there, the siege will be over awfully quick.
Fixing the breach in the wall's a priority.
We won't have time to do much else. Everything settled?
Yes, settled. We don't have much time, so let's get to work.
Let's sum up. Yennefer will create a magic barrier to repel the main assault. That should push the opposing force into the woods, where Lambert and Geralt will be waiting. They'll use Dimeridium to close the Navigator's portals, stop as many warriors as possible from entering the fortress. Triss will be waiting for their signal, then give the Riders hell. All others will repel any foes who make it inside the fortress walls.
If anything goes wrong, we abandon the outer courtyard, pull back to the keep. Remember, Aridin can't get his hands on Ciri. That's most important. Let's look at the map of the fortress, figure out the details. Can't help feeling we've overlooked something important.
Don't think about it.
What's ready?
Haven't had much time to prepare, so not much, honestly.
I'm exposing you all to danger, unnecessarily.
You worry too much. Wipe that frown off your face, we'll make it.
Thanks for everything.
I'll saddle the horses. Come once you're ready to head into the woods.
Got a minute?
Oh, serious talk coming.
They're after you. No matter what happens, you can't put yourself in danger.
Want me to sit and wait while others risk their lives for me?
Listen to me this once. Don't take matters into your own hands.
Don't treat me like a child.
Didn't even do that when you were one.
I like it when you smile. Come here. Everything will be all right.
Gonna have to thank Yen once this is all over. That spell, really something. And the invisibility.
Hounds could sniff you out, so don't get too close. And you'll be visible as soon as you start fighting. Remember that. Good work with these bombs, by the way.
Aim at the portals. Be precise. I'm out of dimeridium.
Yen mentioned casting the Erden at the rifts. Said the sign could seal them.
They're here. Time to say hello.
Slow down. Element of surprise is key. Stay hidden. Give Triss a chance to show them what she can do. Then we'll hit them.
Next time you get the feeling I'm about to piss off Marigold, make sure and knock me upside the head. Geralt! Come here! Look! They're regrouping!
See the commander? Name's Imlarith. I remember him from back when I rode with the Hunt.
Damn it. Spell's waning. We're becoming visible. What's with Marigold?
Shit.
You were meant to wait inside!
I refuse to sit idle while you risk your lives for me.
Back inside!
No! Geralt gave the signal from the woods, and Triss hasn't cast the spell.
Damn it! All right, run to her.
Ciri! Watch out!
Yeah.
Geralt!
Head back.
Detachment approaching from the woods. We need to close the gate before they get inside.
Ladana.
Without me, would you? Come now, admit it.
Lambert, damn it! Stay with us! We gotta pull back! Yennefer's strength is waning! Heads up!
Where's Esko?
Damn it! We agreed he'd open that gate.
Hasn't done it yet. Means...
he'll be fine. We've got Triss to worry about now.
Everything all right?
Yes, thanks. Things were looking shaky.
We had to fall back. They tried to get in through the main gate. I'm afraid they could succeed next time.
What's with Esko? We have to retreat! He's in trouble! I'm going to help him! Remember the stone I gave you!
do it too.
Your ass down like you were supposed to.
Who would have saved yours then?
Eskos, open the gate! We can retreat beyond it!
Fall back!
You're not supposed to be out here.
Too late now!
They're coming in through the gaps!
Time iridium bombs. You'll find more in the crates by the walls. Ciri, no! I forbid you! You always were an unruly child. I adored that about you.
No! I was too late to help him.
It's not your fault.
I should not have fled here to Kaer Morhen.
Avalok is weak, but alive. Triss is tending to the others.
I nearly killed you. Killed everyone.
We'd all be dead if not for you.
No, Geralt. The hunt would never have come to Kaer Morhen if I wasn't here.
Vesemir's funeral. We should prepare. Yourself. No witcher's ever died in his own bed.
You don't know how it is to see someone you love die because of you. For you.
We all knew what we were signing up for.
Yes. And you saved me. For how long? A week? A month?
We'll hide you. Cover your tracks.
No. I will flee no more.
Vafail. For those who remain, death should never take precedence over life. Pay your last respects to your friend. Then we must hold counsel.
Next time on The Witcher 3.
Haven't had a chance to talk. Thanks for your help. And for looking after Ciri.
You will thank me later. Now we must take Ciri from here, hide her. and then gather a greater force.
Anyone, everyone we could count on came here to Kaer Morhen.
Jirel possesses a great power she cannot control. She is a danger to herself, to others. Until she learns to control it, she should remain isolated.
It's not working, don't you see?
Discouraged after a mere 8 attempts? Ciri.
How many times must I try?
As many as it takes.
Bollocks. Second, if you're going to speak of courage, at least address me directly, and not through Geralt. I'm gone.